Guys, welcome to our channel. So today's session we are going to discuss about 8086 microprocessor flag register. In the previous session we discussed about the internal architecture of 8086 microprocessor. Okay, so this session we deeply explain the flag register structure. Okay, so before going the topic, first you know the function of flag register. So what is flag register? So flag register is mainly used to find the status of ALU. So after execution of ALU, arithmetic and logical function, so what is the result produced in ALU? What is the status? That we will check in a flag register. Then here the 8086 microprocessor here classified the two types of flag register. First one is control, then second one is a status. Here we can check the control, then check the status of ALU. So this is the two types of flag register. It's the structure of flag register. In this microprocessor, the flag register content is a 16-bit register. So it starts from 0 to 15. So in this flag register, here we represent the 9-bit. So 9-bit used for flag. So remaining 7 bits are unused bit. So remaining 7 bits are unused, so only here using the 9 bits of flag registers. It's namely called as OF. So OF stands for overflow flag. DF, it's a direction flag. IF, interrupt flag. TF, trap flag. SF, sign flag. ZF, zero. AX, auxiliary carry. PF, parity. And CF, carry flag. So these are the 9 flags affected in the 8086 flag registers. We will discuss one by one. The first flag register is OF. So OF for overflow flag. So in this flag, when this flag is set, the range of output is greater than the input. Okay. So the range of output is greater than the input, that time only set the overflow flag. For example, the multiplication of two 16-bit number, we can produce the result is 32-bit of numbers. So here the range of input is 16-bit, but the output range is 32-bit. So it exceeds the input values. So in this case only set the overflow flag. So overflow flag set to 1. The next one of flag register status is DF. So DF is direction flag. So in this instruction, direction flag is used for string instruction. So this direction flag affect only in a string instruction. Whether the memory access is top to bottom or bottom to top. The accessing memory is top to bottom or bottom to top, that will indicate in a direction flag. So suppose the direction flag value equal to 1, the memory access is top to bottom. Suppose this flag is set to 0, now the memory access is bottom to top. The third one is IF, so interrupt flag. Interrupt flag means whether the 8086 microprocessor is provide the service for the corresponding interrupt. So that indicate in an interrupt flag. Suppose this flag equal to 1, enabling the interrupt. Suppose this value equal to 0, disable all the interrupts. So this flag is identified whether the microprocessor is provide the service for interrupt or disable the interrupt service. The next one is trap flag. So trap flag is namely called as single step flag. So in 8086 microprocessor, the architecture itself I told, the instruction register store the instruction, that instruction is passed to instruction queue. So here, so in this instruction queue, it stored the 6 number of instruction. It fetched the first instruction. Okay, so this first instruction fetching and decode and execute. So this function also called as a one type of software interrupt. Okay, so its indicate in software interrupt. So the trap flag always 1. So each and every time you get the instructions from the instruction register to the microprocessor, it process the processing time. So it's also take as a software interrupt. The next one is SF. So SF stands for sign flag. Whether the result is positive value or negative value. So in this flag set, the MSB bit. So after subtraction function, the MSB bit set to be 1. So it's a negative value. Suppose the MSB bit is 0. So it's a positive value. So that indicate in sign flag register. The next one is zero flag. So zero flag represent the final result of ALU, all the bits are 0 or non-zero. Suppose all the bits are 0, the zero flag set to be 1. Suppose all the bits are non-zero, so the zero flag set to be 0. The next flag is auxiliary carry flag. So this auxiliary carry flag is mainly used for the BCD addition. So BCD addition or subtraction. So after execution of the BCD addition or subtraction function, the final result is valid BCD or invalid BCD. That will check with the help of AX. Okay. So the condition also we discussed in the previous video. Just you refer. Here the auxiliary carry. When the auxiliary carry is produced, middle of the bit, any overflow occur. So that's called as an auxiliary carry. Suppose this microprocessor is a 16-bit microprocessor. In the 8th bit, any overflow occur. So that's called as an auxiliary carry. The next status is PF. So PF means parity flag. Whether the result is odd parity of numbers or even parity of numbers present in the result, that will check with the help of the parity flag. Suppose here all numbers of ones or even numbers of one. Based on that you can set the parity. Suppose even numbers of one means the parity flag set to be 1. Odd parity means the parity flag set to be 0. The final one is carry flag. So this carry flag, when set the carry flag means, so here the end of the bit. End of the bit, any overflow occur, that's called as a carry flag. So it's a structure of 8086 microprocessor flag register. So thanks for watching my channel. Please subscribe.